Our friends have fought and bled and died alongside us in Afghanistan. And now we must come together to end this war successfully.
President Obama talking about our allies as he lays out his plan for Afghanistan, which includes sending 30,000 more U.S. troops and beginning to pull out in July 2011.
Now for a closer look at the speech, we're joined by political analyst Dr. Terry Madonna. Dr. Madonna, first of all, what did you think of the speech? How do you think it's being received?
Well, first of all, I think the president made the right decision. I mean, the strategy, the redoing of the strategy makes a lot of sense. I think fundamentally here's the problem. The president said during the course of the speech that this was the necessary war. He also said that we have, our resolve is unwavering. But the problem then is, he said, we're going to start to pull out within 18 months. That's inconsistent. When we did the surge in Iraq, which not arguably the American people didn't favor, but which worked, no time limits at all.
Well, a lot of critics are, that's one thing they're keying in on, the fact that there is basically an 18-month timetable for withdrawal.
That's correct. I mean, what happens when we get to the 18-month period and the benchmarks, whatever they are, and remember, we don't have, we're supposed to deal with the Karzai administration, what benchmarks are we going to use to make sure that, this corrupt government that countenances drug dealers is doing what they should? It may take longer than 18 months, and then we will have sacrificed men in vain. So that's the fundamental problem.
Well, clearly the president says the strategy, part of the strategy, is to closely monitor what is going on politically in Afghanistan.
If he can sustain it politically. The liberals in his own party are already reacting very strongly negatively to it. Actually, conservatives are more on his side on this because they believe in the surge and want it to play out to the very end. The president's in a very tough political situation as we speak.
Which brings us to the question raised by Senator Arlen Specter. He came out and said he opposes troop increase. So what do you make of that?
And his opponent, Joe Sestak, of course, in favor of.
Yeah, I mean, first of all, that's the big difference we now see between the two candidates that are waging an almost holy war in this race for the U.S. Senate nomination. I think Arlen Specter raised the question earlier in the week when he said he might not support the president and the surge, and he's now said no. So we'll see where that all plays out. It's going to be maybe the biggest issue in the U.S. Senate race. We now might have it in the difference between Sestak and
Specter. Say that maybe because Specter is trying to appeal to the Democratic base.
No doubt about it. The liberal base of the party. Now, Sestak, who's, you know, the admiral, the military guy, supports the president. It's going to be fascinating what the liberal base, and particularly in southeastern Pennsylvania in our state and up in the Lehigh Valley, where we have a lot more sort of liberal Democrats than anywhere else.
It's kind of weird, though, because they want the president to, you know, obviously a Democratic president. They want him to succeed
as but
well.
The liberal interest groups, MoveOn.org and others have come out against this plan. This is really dividing the Democratic Party.
So they call it another Vietnam, too.
Well, it's not another Vietnam. The president is right about that. It is not a Vietnam.
The next year and a half, we'll tell the story of what happens in Afghanistan and our role in that country.
I think you're right. Very critical.
Dr. Madonna, as always, thank you for joining us on News 8.